こんにちは。本日は第8回世界盆栽大会 in 埼玉、日本の盆栽集積手法展、手法展ステージへようこそお越しくださいました。このステージでは盆栽デモンストレーションをはじめ多彩なプログラムを毎日お届けしております。ご挨拶が遅れましたが、本日の司会進行を務めさせていただきます、荒山美和子と申します。どうぞよろしくお願いいたします。さあ、それでは今回のプログラムをご紹介したいと思います。中国よりお越しのダオ・チンチュエンさん、そしてアメリカよりお越しのビヨン・ビオホルムさんによる盆栽デモンストレーションです。ではここでお二人のプロフィールを簡単にご紹介させていただきますが、通訳の方をお呼びしたいと思います。今回のデモンストレーションを担当してくださるビヨンさんにお願いしたいと思います。ビヨンさん、お願いします。
Hello everybody。
はい、今回のですね、主役の方に通訳をお願いするのはちょっと恐縮なんですけれども、よろしくお願いします。はい、ではまず、ジャオ・チンチェンさんは中国の江蘇省のご出身で、40年以上にわたり盆栽作家として活動しており、過去3回の世界盆栽大会でデモンストレーションを開催、今回が4回目となります。
So first we're going to introduce to you Mr. Zhao from China. He's been doing bonsai for over 40 years and he's been a demonstrator at 3 previous World Bonsai Conventions. So this will make his 4th convention.
世界各国で盆栽のデモンストレーションを実施したり、盆栽関連の著書を多数執筆するなど、盆栽文化の普及拡大に努めています。
He travels all around the world teaching bonsai and he focuses on landscape Penjing.
さあ、続いてビヨンさんの、はい、経歴をご紹介したいと思います。ビヨン・ビオホルムさんはアメリカ・テネシー州のご出身。13歳の時に盆栽に出会います。2008年大学を卒業後来日し、大阪の藤川光華園の藤川圭一さんに弟子入りし、盆栽の修行を始め、2015年には日本盆栽協同組合より盆栽プロとしての修了証を授与されています。
So I'll introduce myself. My name is Bjorn Bjornholm. I'm from the United States originally. I started bonsai when I was 13 years old. After I graduated from university in 2008, I came to study bonsai at Fujikawa Kokkaen in Osaka. I was there for 6 years as an apprentice. I graduated a few years ago and I've been working as a bonsai professional in Japan for the last 3 years.
そしてビヨンさんは現在も大阪に暮らし、藤川光華園に勤める傍ら、ご自身の盆栽スタジオを運営されています。また1年の半分は海外に赴き、ワークショップやデモンストレーションを通じて盆栽の魅力を世界中に伝えています。
Today I continue to live in Osaka and I travel around the world about half a year every year. So 6 months out of the year I'm on the road traveling to different countries teaching bonsai.
さあ、それではお呼びしたいと思います。ジャオ・チンチュエンさん、そしてここにいらっしゃるビヨン・ビオホルムさん、そして解説をお務めいただきます磯部茂雄さん、通訳をお務めいただきますチュエン・ナンシーさん、アシスタントの大島健二さん、今井千春さん、森山義彦さん、前川直樹さんです。よろしくお願いいたします。
These will be the assistants for today and this is Mr. Zhao from China.
さあ、では皆さんよろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
はい、よろしくお願いします。
はい、
はい、わかりました。じゃあそれではビヨンさん、よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
じゃあよろしくお願いします。
皆さんこんにちは。楽しんでますか？Is everybody having a good time? Excellent. 今日はですね、この赤松に、針金をかけていきたいと思うんですけれども、Today I'm going to be working on this red pine and we're going to be creating hopefully a nice bonsai out of it today.
大阪から僕のお友達がお手伝いに来てるんですけど、前岡直樹さんっていうんですけれども、同じ藤川光華園で修行、した人ですね。
This is Mayoka-san. He came all the way up from Osaka to help me with the demonstration today. We both studied at Fujikawa Kokkaen in Osaka, so he completed his apprenticeship there a few years ago as well. Okay, so First thing first with this tree, obviously it's a very large tree. We only have 2 hours to get this done, so we're going to have to work quite hard. It's about 120 centimeters tall right now. My goal is to take it down to about 80 centimeters.
今日は2時間しかないので、今の状態では120センチぐらいの高さなんですけど、2時間だけで80センチにしようと思ってて、そうしないと終わらないので。
So first thing, what we're going to do, I'm not going to change the planting angle too severely on the tree, but I am going to tilt it slightly further forward. To me, if you look at the tree from, let's see, from the side, it appears as if it's leaning slightly towards the back. So I want to tilt this tree forward, and I'm going to use this as the front because this area is very interesting. I'm not going to worry about tilting the tree from side to side. I think the angle works quite well as it is.
この木の一番面白い部分は、幹の、この辺なんですけど、でそれを見せるために正面はこっちにします。で、こっちから見ると幹がちょっと後ろに倒れてるみたいな感じだから、鉢の下にちょっと棒を入れときます。そうすると頭がちょっと前にかぶるようになります。で、そうすると木がもっと大きく見えて力が出てきます。So if we do it this way and pull the tree slightly forward like this, bringing the apex forward like this, it makes the tree feel a bit more powerful, and a bit more weighted, a bit older as well. So that's why I'm going to do this. What I'm going to do now is cut off the unnecessary branches on the tree. So if you can see this branch here,it's been brought down and it's actually grafted onto the trunk down here. That was probably done 4 or 5 years ago. I'm going to remove this whole upper portion and keep just the lower branches down here, and then we'll build the tree out of this.
多分 4、5 年前にこの枝が上から下へ持っていって、で、ここに継いでありますよ。でも十分継いであるので、この上の部分はもう切っても全然大丈夫だから、今日はそれを切ります。
Okay, so for now I'm going to pass it on to Mr. Zhao on the other side of the stage there, while I cut the branches off of this. Okay, やりましょう。
それでは、ジャオさん、どのような寄せ植えの構想を、お持ちでしょうか。
好的 ，OK。我来自中国，在中国从古代开始就喜爱盆景。
I'm from China and I've been liking 盆景 for a long time. 中国から参りました。ずっと盆栽ということ好きです。
中国的绘画当中有一种叫山水画。
There is a kind of painting. It's called traditional landscape Chinese painting. 中国の山水画というものがあります。
中国人做盆景有很多都是参照这种山水画来制作的。
A lot of Chinese people we based our style on this landscape Chinese traditional painting.
今天呢，我想做一盆就是丛林的，用这个五针松做一盆丛林的盆景。
Today we're going to make a forest. 今日は寄せ植えというスタイルになります。
所有这些树都是日本的。
These trees are all from Japan. この木は全部日本のものになります。
我呢，我从中国带来一点石头。
These rocks are from China. この石は中国から持ってきました。
下面呢我就开始来做啊。这个今天呢，他们有三位先生。给我做助手，所以担心我这个来不及完成。
Fortunately, today we have two professionals helping me, because it's going to be a really big project, and they are worried that I'm not be able to finish it in time. 今日は二人のプロが手伝っていただいてすごく光栄です。ありがとうございます。
做这个丛林的盆景，最第一步就是要把。这个主树，要选出来，就是最高最大的一棵树要挑选出来。
The most important thing is to choose the parent plant at first. 最も重要なのは最初から親 木というものを選ぶことです。
这棵就是准备作为主树的。
I'm going to use that as the parent plant. これは今日のお焼きになります。
我要去听一下。这棵树，我想和它相配。
I'm gonna use this smaller tree to pair with the big tree. この小さい木とこのおやきを今日、組みたいと思っています。
これからフラットのやつでもいいんですけど。So as we're working on the trees today, if you guys have any questions about anything, feel free to shout them out. They can be in Japanese or in English. That's fine. You can ask in Chinese too. Nancy will translate it from Chinese. So, 何か質問があればぜひ聞いてください。はい。ないですか。で、この枝を見てください。すごく長くて、で、あんまり、この辺に懐目がないので使いにくいですよ。Take a look at this branch right here. It's quite long. There really aren't many back buds on the branch, particularly in this area here, and it's very difficult to use. So what I want to do with this tree today is compact it as much as possible to really bring out the weight of the trunk there. So I'm going to get rid of most of this branch here. I'm going to leave this smaller branch at the base, right? So there'll be a combination of this and this that we're going to keep.For the main branch in this area to help sort of frame the dead wood here, but this long branch is unnecessary right now.
じゃあもう来ていこうか。それではジャオさん、寄せ植えに点につきまして一番難しいこと、一番考えることというのはジャンさんどういうことをお考えでしょうか。
做这种丛林的盆景，最困难的就是要怎么样这个把这个树来进行配置。如果把这些树都种在一个盆里面呢，很容易。难的就是说怎么样最后做出来一种画意，像一幅画一样。我们做的呢，就是要把这种中国的传统文化里面的这种组合式，那个虚和实、疏和灭这些等等等等变化，把它做出来。所以说，这一步是最困难的。
こういう寄せ植え、一番難しいと思っているのが、この単なる鉢に植えることはすごく簡単だと思うんですけど。この一番大事な難しいというのはこの組み合わせ、あとどうやってその中国の山水画みたいなように美しく並ぶということが一番難しいと思っています。So he thinks it's if you just want to plant all the trees in a pot is very easy, but the most difficult part would be how to match it.To make it as looks like the traditional Chinese landscape painting, and also the how do you place it in a pot and to make it look more natural, he thinks that's the most difficult part.
ビヨンさんは今どのような作業をやってらっしゃいますか？
そうですね、さっきこの長い枝を切っちゃって、で、この残ってる部分はちょっと小さくしてます。はい。で、ここから屋根がいっぱい出てくるので、このデモが終わってから、カットパストを貼らないといけないですね。はい。So right now, after cutting this branch back, I'm cutting the stub quite close back to the secondary branch here. There's going to be a lot of, Yanni, sap that comes out of the branch right here. So after the demo's over today, we'll have to put some cut paste on that to keep it from bleeding out. In the future, this branch will actually be completely removed. I'm only leaving it today to kind of fill in a bit of space here and to keep a bit more photosynthetic surface on the tree, so to have a bit more green on the plant to keep the tree alive and healthy. But in the future, this will be cut off. And the reason for that is because this will actually become our main branch. It's probably quite difficult to see from where you are, but these two branches exit out of the trunk at slightly different heights, but they're almost right on top of each other, and that's not ideal in design. So 将来にこの枝は全部切っちゃうんですけど、今日全部切るとあの葉っぱがあまり少なくなると木が弱ってしまう場合もあります。だから今日はまあちょっと残しておきます。
ジャンさんのは主木のようなが決まりましたので、どちらが正面という形で構想しているでしょうか。
哎，我在想这个上面，因为这个树方向是在树是向这个方向的，盆子我只好这样用。
今ここ、こういうふうにここ正面になるんですけど、で流れは右になります。So this is going to be the front of the tree, I mean, the front of the bonsai, and it's going to flow towards the left.
So at this stage, I'm not exactly sure if we're going to keep this gin at the top here, or if we're going to keep it as long as I've left it for now. But what I'm going to do to begin with is just peel quite a bit of the bark off of here, see what it looks like when we put the apex into place, and then we can decide if we want to remove that completely or shorten it or make it thinner. Right? 今の状態でこのジンはちょっとうるさいんですけど、今から皮を取ってでちょっと小さくするんですけど、頭に針金をかけてで形を作ってたら、これはまだ邪魔だったらもう全部切ってもいいし、もっと短くしても大丈夫だから、とりあえず置いておきます。
我现在我是在还在哎，还在。还在考虑了整个的构思，刚才做。把一个三棵树的一个位置。大体上定下来，也可能还要有一些变化。
For now, I just placed all these three trees. But I'm probably gonna move it later. 今とりあえずこの三つの木を固定してるんですけど、まだ動かすかもしれません。正面是哪边？哪边是正面？
对面。
So this is going to be the front. こちらから見て正面になります。
So, after you, go ahead.
这一步呢是最麻烦的这一道程序。如果是定不好，后面就做不好。所以有的时候要反反复复的修改。
Now it's the critical stage. If you don't get it right now, then you have to make lots of changes later. 今は最も大切な段階になっています。今がきちんと決まらないと、あとは繰り返す変える必要があります。
All right, so Japanese red pines are notoriously brittle. The branches break very easily. So I was a bit worried about doing this tree for a demonstration like this. I thought it would be quite risky. But I checked the tree in the back over there and bent some of the branches around. You can notice they're very, very flexible on this tree. It's more like a black pine than a red pine, which is great. That's really good news. So we're not actually going to be using any raffia on this tree today. 普段はあの赤松っていうのが枝がすごく硬くて折れやすいです。ですけれどもこの木はちょっと違って、まあ、あの赤松なんですけどあの枝が全然大丈夫ですよね。こうするとなんか黒松みたいな感じで大丈夫だからあの今日はラフィアは使わないです。いやそうです。キープ。
だから我现在慢慢的由三棵树变成了五棵树。
Now, I'm adding more trees to it. Now you can see there are 5 trees.
这个在 这种丛林的布局里面，里面所有的三棵树最后都不要成一个直线，成一个不等边的三角形。像这个三棵树了，等一下还要来调整，还调整。
So in this style.Any three trees, they cannot line up together because if they line up in a line, when you look at it, it's going to look like one tree. あのこの、上寄せっていうのはどこから見ても3つの木がまっすぐになってはいけないんです。なぜかというとまっすぐになると全部1個の木に見えてしまうんですので、これちょっとずれてあのいろんな角度から見えるようにします。
So this particular gin right here is very heavy. It's large and sort of in your face. So I want to make that as small as I possibly can. So what I'm doing now, I cut back the end a little bit shorter, and I'm taking the saw, putting it on an angle here. I'm going to slice this on a downward angle and then work the bark off and work the size down a bit further with some of the smaller hand tools.
このジンが今の状態です。すごくあの太くて、うるさいんですよ。だから今僕がやってるのがあのその長い部分をもうちょっと切って、であのここにあの斜めにあのノコギリでちょっと切っていきます。そうするとあのその太さがだんだん小さくなっていって、でそれができたらあのこの道具を使ってあの皮も取ります。
何か質問がありますか? Any questions in the audience? Feel free to shout it out.
Okay. 刚才讲这个，把它金锁丝上一下。这部分要上，这部分要上，这就要上了。最好是全部上一下，我看时间来得及，让全部上一下。我在想还是不用全部上，时间上来得及的，他有三个人应该没问题。
I found some duct tape buried in the tree here, so I don't know why that's there, but...
这个苏波的这个造型上面，就是苏波的修剪攀杂，这个重要的就是空间部分，就是我们呢不主张把它做的全部做留满，留下很多的一些空间，这样的话呢更有一种想象的这种范围更大。
We don't like to make it full. We like to leave lots of spaces in between, so it leaves you to use your imagination.
この全部いっぱい植えることではなく、できるだけスペースを置くことがいいですね。なぜかというと、そのスペースを置くことによって自分の想像力に任せて、いろんな捉え方ができると思います。
I don't think I need to go to the gym today. I think this is a good workout. 今日ジム行かなくていいですよね。
Alright, okay. Hey, okay.
All right, so what I'm doing now is breaking down the tips of the deadwood at the top. Here, I want it to come to a slight point at the end because it looks more natural, and I'm using the concave cutters to twist and peel off the bark. And what I don't want to do is remove all of the bark on the whole thing. I want to leave some of the old bark around the backside. It gives it a bit more of a natural feel to it, rather than peeling everything off.今僕がやってるのがこの天神をちょっと細くしてて、で皮全部取らずに自然に見えるように、多分 50% を取って、で 50% を残します。で将来にその残ってる 50% はもちろん自然でなくなるんですけど、とりあえず自然に見えるように残しておきます。
现在呢，再把几棵树，用金属丝把这个枝搞得垂下来，垂一点。我们比较喜欢就是树这种垂枝的，这样呢就是显出一种老树的这种形态。一般说来，在这个幼年的树是向上长的，然后到了中年呢，慢慢的下垂，慢慢下垂，因为这个血压啦，它本身的重量啦，慢慢垂下来。到了老的树就是比较直的垂下来的。
We're now putting wires on the trees to make them lean down, because if they lean down, it makes them look older, because normally young trees they tend to grow up.
今、針金をかけてて、下向きになってるんです。
なぜかというと下向きになるとこの木は、古く見えるんです。若い木だとするとどうしてもあの上向きになっちゃうので、そうですね、古い木の方がいいです。
在中国的这个黄山有很多的这种松林，山上的这种松林都是这样的，老树枝向两边伸缩，然后再老的松它就开始下垂，这个是所以这样的做是一种符合自然的一种做法。
In China, this a mountain is called Mount Huang, and they have lots of trees that are thousands of years old, and they are all leaning down. And we're doing this to make this bonsai closer to the nature. In China, there are all leaning down, and where doing this to make this bonsai closer to the nature.
So this tool that I'm using right here is very helpful when you're making shari on a tree like this and the bark is difficult to peel off. You can buy these at some of the tool shops over here. This one happens to come from the Kikowa booth, which is right next to the stage here. The Kaneshin booth also sells it as well, so it's quite a good tool to have in your pocket. Jin とかシャリを作るときに、たまに皮が取りにくいので、こういう道具を使ったらすごく取りやすくなります。でこれはキコアの売店で買ったんですけど、キコアの売店でも売ってるし、カネシンの売店でも売ってますので、ぜひ買いに行ってください。はい。
質問ですか？質問を、はい、ちょっと待ちください。
What do you call for it? When you ask for it, what do you address it as?
Just say the one that I'm using up on stage, because he doesn't know the name in Japanese, and I don't know the name of this in English, so.
All right.
Huh? Jin Shari Chou, eh? Jin Shari Chou Kokuto. Jin Shari Chou Kokuto is what you call it. You got it? Jin Shari, no, I can't even say it. All right. とりあえずいいよね。So while I'm finishing up working on the gin at the top here, which isn't going to take much longer, Mayoka-san is going to start to wire some of the lower branches. He's going to work on the branches towards the back, and as soon as I get done with this, I'll start with the ones on the bottom here. これはまだできてないので今からもうちょっと僕はこの部分をやりますけど、マヨクさんが後ろの枝から針金をかけていきます。 All right, so on conifers, typically we use copper wire, right? If this were a deciduous or a broadleaf evergreen, we would more than likely use aluminum wire, or aluminium, as a lot of people say. まあ、小箔だったら普段はあの銅線で針金をかけていくんですけど、あの臓器だったらまあ普段はアルミ線を使います。でこれは小箔だから今日はあの銅線を使います。
现在做的这个过程、啊、是一个比较长一点的过程，因为有好多棵树要把它扎起来，可能就是没有太多的好看的地方。
This process is very long and tedious, so hope I'm not boring you guys.
等一下，
このステップがすごくあの。長くてちょっとつまらないかもしれないんですが、もうちょっとあの待っていただければいいものが出来上がるので。
等一下呢，每一棵树金属丝绕上去以后，把它做一个造型，然后来一拼在以后就可以出现效果。
We are putting wire on all the trees, and then we're going to put them together, to.And then you'll see the final project.
今針金かけてて、で終わってから組み合わせしたり並べたりするので、それであの最後のものになります。
All right. So what Mayoka-san was doing while I was working on the deadwood up here, was he was trimming some of the branches on the tree, and he was looking for areas where there were more than two shoots or branches coming out of the same spot. So if there are three, four, five coming out of the same spot, he cut that back to two in each area. Right? Ideally, we want to pick the two lateral pieces, the two lateral buds or branches, so we can pull them down and get a bifurcating structure. The reason we want to cut back to two on a pine like this is because if you leave three or more in one spot, at the base there, it's going to start to swell and get really fat over time. It might look nice to keep all that foliage there. It'll look full.But in the long run, you're going to have problems.
松っていうのが一つのところから三つの芽か枝が出てきたら、その部分が太くなります。だからマヨクさんがさっき全体的に切っていたんですけど、三つか四つか五つがあったら必ず二つにしました。そうしないと。その部分が太くなります。2つにしたら太くならないです。
like this branch. Okay. Yeah, the question was, is it not really aesthetically pleasing to have a branch come from the inside of the curve? In a lot of cases, as a general sort of rule of thumb, that's true. It would be better not to have something come right from the inside of the curve. But we do need a branch on this side of the tree, and this is going to become the main branch, the sashieda right here. That's going to provide the directionality for the tree. So we need something in this area. So in my opinion, it's less important where the branch comes out of the trunk and more important where that pad actually ends up, either in creating directionality or flow or in framing an important part of the tree. And in the case of this branch, it does both. It frames this lower area, and it also creates the directionality to the plant.
普段はこういうカーブの中に枝が出てきたらちょっとあんまり綺麗に見えないんですけど、まあ出てるところじゃなくてその枝があのどこに持っていくっていうのがそれそっちの方が大切だと思います。それ信じてますか?
I don't think so. Everybody's just staring at me. Okay.
Okay. 这个方向。
Okay, so we're wiring the branches right now, working from the inside of the tree out, and we typically start at the bottom and work our way up. We're not going to be wiring every single teeny tiny little bud on the tree today. It's not necessary. So what I'm doing and what my Oak-san is doing is we're strategically picking which branches need to be wired and which ones don't. So just as an example here, it's probably difficult to see from the audience, but I wired this branch, and there's two buds at the end. It bifurcates at the end. I took the wire out onto the largest of those two tips at the end and lifted it up. And in doing so, that lifted the smaller one up with it. So it's not necessary now to go back and wire the smaller tip. So when you're wiring your trees, think about that. Strategically pick which branches need wire and which ones don't. It'll save you time and money. Yes. Okay.
今、針金をかけてるんですけど、あの、
全部の枝じゃなくて必要な枝だけをかけてます。Okay, and the question was just now, what is Maioka-san doing to the back of the tree here? Is he putting a guy wire on? The answer is yes, he is putting a guy wire on the back. So he put wrapped wire on the branch first, and now he's applying the guy wire to pull that branch down into position because the wrapped wire isn't going to be strong enough to hold it down. So he's anchored it. Let's spin this around here. ちょっと回していこうか. So if you can see here, he put the wrapped wire on first, then he took the guy wire and anchored it to this small gin at the bottom of the tree here. brought the guy wire up and had the two ends meet on top of the wrapped wire. There's several ways to do this. He could have attached this through the wrapped wire here and pull from the bottom. In this case, it's a little hard to get this tool under here to pull and twist, so he went with putting the two wires on top here. And by putting the two wires together on top of the wrapped wire, that wrapped wire will serve as a buffer between the guy wire and the branch, so there's no risk of it biting into the branch.
今、マヨクさんがやってるのが、まあ、この枝を下げたいので、最初には針金を巻いて、で、巻いてから、まあ、この巻いてる針金が、なんていうの、まあ、効かないので、引っ張ってる針金を使ってます。で、この陣の下から上まで行って、で、その巻いてる針金の上で引っ張ってます。そうすると、枝に、なんていうの、食い込まないです。はい。
So I'll tell a small story here. When I was a kid, I had Mr. Zhao's book, Penjing Worlds of Wonder. I don't know if you guys have seen that book. It's a really cool book. So I had it in middle school, and you know, it's not really cool to do bonsai if you're in middle school. You're definitely going to get picked on by your friends. But I loved this book so much, I would carry it to school with me every day. And when I had free time, I'd sneak off to the bathroom and I'd read his book in the bathroom so my friends wouldn't make fun of me. So it's an honor to be on the stage with him today.
僕は中学生の時に隣のザオさんの本を持ってて、で、毎日、学校行った時に、その本を持って行って、で、友達にいじめられないようにこそりでトイレで見てました、毎日。で、今日お互いにステージで、でもやってるのは僕にはすごく光栄です。
Nancy translated that for him backstage. I told him the story beforehand. So,
some soya. Soya. 就是来一点土垫在下面，把这个树固定起来。
So I've been working with Mayoka-san for... 最初に高校に来た時に何年でしたっけ? So I came to Kokan about 2 years before Mayoka-san, and so I came about 9 years ago to begin with, and he came 2 years after that. So we've been working together at Kokan for 7 years together at this point, but this is the first time we've actually worked on a tree together. So...it's exciting, it's fun.
僕は最初に公開に来た時にも9年間前でしたけど、まあ、で、前奥さんが、まあ、7年前、その同じ公開に入って、だから、まあ、7年間お互いに仕事やってるんですけど、実際は、今日は初めてお互いに同じ木を針金かけていってます。
Question was, how's he doing?マークさんの針金かけ方はどうですかって聞かれてるんですけど、素晴らしいです。He's doing a good job. He's doing a good job. Of course. Yes. Hold on. We'll bring you the microphone.
Yeah, I just have a question about needle c cutting, you see like some trees in the vendor area, they cut the needles, some don't. You even see it in exhibitions. So basically, what is your opinion on it, and when would you recommend to do it, and when not?
That's a very good question. Did everybody hear the question? Okay. So typically, I don't recommend that you cut the needles on a pine. You can do that if you want to make it look a bit cleaner. Typically, you'll see it mostly done on black pines in Japan, not on all of them, and not every tree will have a lot of needles cut. You might have some that have a few cut here and there, but you very, very rarely see it on a red pine. The needles are a bit softer on this species, and the tips will turn quite brown, whereas a black pine, they tend to be a bit harder, and if you spray them afterwards for several days, the tips don't turn too brown. So it's okay, but I don't recommend doing it. If you could control the length of the needles through candle pruning in the summer, you're better off doing that than cutting the needles.
先の質問が松の葉っぱについての話なんですけど、売店に置いてある黒松とか赤松見たら、葉っぱが切られてるやつが結構多いって言ったんですけど、でそれは普通ですかって聞かれてたんですよ。で、まあ僕にとってはあんまり切らない方がいいと思うんですけど、まあ葉っぱが同じサイズになるために切っても大丈夫ですけど、芽切りで夏の間に芽切りで葉っぱが同じサイズにするようなことができた方がいいと思うんですよ、葉っぱを切るより。That makes sense? I'm getting a lot of blank stares from the Japanese, so, okay. Okay, Mayoku-san said it made sense, so we're good, all right.
Wait a another tree. The lake,树过来。这种丛林的种树呢，它比较麻烦，它一定要，要相互配合好。就是说，现在的固定这棵树只能初步的定，等到其他的树都放进来的时候，看呢，可能在位置上面还要做一些调整。
It's very difficult to make the forest. I'm just putting this parent plant in the middle for now. I have to wait for all the other trees get ready and then place them and adjust them at the same time. こういう植え寄せというのはすごく難しいというのは、全部持ってきて、同時に、合わせたりとかしないといけないんです。なので今また2つ待っています。
Nanchi, could you ask him how he prepared the slab and how the wires were attached?
So there are lots of holes on this plate.And he just put wire through underneath and pulled them out and then fixed the trees to make them attached. この鉢はたくさんの穴が開いてます。で、下からワイヤが通って、で、これワイヤを使ってこの木を固定しています。
用点这个粘土把这个把旁边围一围，然后这个才这样的这个土的话就不会跑到外面去了。
I'm using the wet sand on the outside and the dryer in the inside, so the sand wouldn't get everywhere. 今はその濡れている
土を使って外を囲んでいます。で、中はちょっと乾いたまた別の土を使って、そうすることによって、外に流れ込むことがないようにしています。
Is it real stone or is it constructed man-made slab?
Made. This is made. Like 仿造天然的.
This stand is actually man-made. It's not natural.It's a ceramic.
この、
質問は、これは天然物ですか、作り物ですかっていうの、これは陶器です、作り物です。
Could you describe his recipe for the wet sand, please?
This is what they have provided. This is using the soil and there is a like a grass plant. We usually use sand tag to make it.
This actually the Bonsai Association provided this, so, yep.
用这个就是粘土和这个一个正经的是什么？你问一下他，他这是用的手根。
It's peat muck.
Muck. Muck.
Muck. この土の配合について聞かれてるんですけど、ケトです。
Does anyone have any questions?
Does anyone have any questions?
Sorry. 何か質問があればぜひ聞いてくださいよ。
Bjorn, are you staying true to your original vision to that tree when you first saw it, or are you adjusting it as you're working with it?
I would say I'm sticking pretty closely to kind of what I had in mind when I first saw the tree. In a majority of cases, I can tell what I want to do with a plant within the first couple of minutes of seeing it. There are a few what I would call semi-objective things that you can look for in terms of designing a tree that'll at least give you sort of a base to go from in terms of design. So, for example, I want to show off the most interesting part of the tree, and that can mean a lot of different things. In the case of this tree, it's this area down here where you have the beautiful shari and the dead wood here, the sabamiki, the hollow trunk. I want to show that off. So that's why I picked that as the front. In terms of the angle of the tree, there's lots of different options. My first thought with the tree was to actually tilt it slightly more to the left so that this section right here wasn't so perpendicular to the ground. But when we tried to do that, what happened was the apex became more difficult to design and build. So there was a bit of a compromise there. So instead of tilting it to the left, we just lifted the back up to bring the apex slightly further forward. So you end up with a bit of a perpendicular look to the trunk here. But I think in placing the branches, we can frame this so your eye goes to this first, then moves up the trunk, then you see the apex and the balance to the full tree. So, but to answer your initial question, yes, I'm sticking pretty closely to what I had in mind right from the start. Okay. 最初にはこの木を見たときに、最初はちょっとボサボサだったんですけど、最初に見たときにどういう、結局どういうデザインになるかっても最初から分かってたんですかとさっき聞かれたんですけど、で大体初めて見たときにで、そのイメージを持ってで今はそのイメージは作ってるんで、であんまり変わってないです最初から。 Very good question though.
When Mr. Takayama built a forest of trident maples, you will have to translate. When Mr. Takayama built a forest of trident maples, he told us that he intentionally selected some more mature and refined trees than he would normally use so that we, the audience, could get a better sense at the end of the demonstration how the forest would look in the future. Are these...the kinds, the age and the refinement that he would usually select at this stage of building this pinjing, or has he selected special, more refined, to give us a better sense the way that Mr. Takayama did?
質問は、高山先生のデモの時は、もっと熟成した木を選びました、なぜかというとその、普段よりもっと熟成した木を選ぶことによってその皆さんに分かりやすく、スタイルできるからということでしたが、この今日の、ジャオ先生は今日選んだ木は普段と違うでしょうかっていう質問です。
大体上差不多，稍微有一点不一样，稍微有一点，我在这个树的这些材料都是已经做过加工的，都是做过盘扎的。我在中国做的时候呢，喜欢就是刚才我讲的，把枝全部做得很垂的那种，但这样的也可以的，也是可以，就是有一点点不一样。我其实不是更老的，就是开始做的树的时候，我做成是这样的。这挂下来的枝，材料是自己要靠自己加工的，要靠自己做。这个现在因为是表演，不可能自己做了。
Normally he would
Well, today all the materials were provided, and they are already semi-made. But normally he would style them maybe a little different, like leaning down a little bit. But the material itself is pretty much the same. 普段は針金かけるときは若干違うですが、でもその素材としては普段とあんまり変わらない素材を使っています。
すいません。盆栽が出来上がってその根は何年に1回か切るんじゃないかと思うんですけども、根っこは切るときどういうふうに見極めて根っこを切り落とすんでしょうか。両方ともこっちの鉢もこっちの鉢も根をいつ切って整理するか、その検討のつけどころと、それからあと水をどれぐらいに1回やるのか、ちょっと、はいはい、いつはああいう大きいのはいついじるかなと思うんです。
ビオン、大きい木はいつ、最適にこういう改作をする時期はいつですかという
。針金かける時期ですか。あ、はい。根っこ切る時期ですか。まあ新芽がちょっと出る前に、ちょっとだけ出る前に、まあ植え替えることはできて、まあそのまあ大体3月の初め頃から まあ、3月の間に植え替えることはできるんですけど、実はこういう針金をかけることは、まあ、今の時期はあんまり良くないですよ。なぜかというと新芽が出てきてるからすごく折れやすいです。だから、まあ、新芽が出てくる前か6月に芽切りしてからの方が、まあ、その時に針金かけた方がいいですね。実は、まあ、今の時期はあんまり良くないです。はい、はい、根も切るのも3月です。はい。あ、そうですね。あ、何年に1回根を切っても大丈夫ですかと聞かれてるんですけど、まあこういう古い松だったら、まあ5年間に1回とか6年間もなるべくまあ植え替えてからなるべく長い間に、まあ、そのままにして、で土が詰まってから。Okay.植え替えた方がいいですよね。水があんまり入らなくなると植え替えした方がいいですよね。 So the question was, when's the best time to repot a red pine like this, and work on the roots? Sometime in March is usually the best time to do it. And the secondary question was, how long should you leave between each time that you repot a tree like this? So an old tree like this,you can leave it probably 5, 6, 7 years. The longer, the better. Every time you repot an old tree like this, particularly a pine, it's difficult to decandle that tree that same year. The tree will weaken to some degree, and you lose a year of ramification development on the tree. So you're better off leaving it as long as possible until the soil actually becomes compacted, and then repotting at that point. So it's case by case, depends on the tree. But...Typically, you know, 4, 5, 6, 7 years, if you can, would be ideal for a pine like this. Yes. I can't hear anything you're saying. ちょっと、マイク持ってきてください。
It's a general question on designing your tree here.You have this very interesting feature, you know, at the base of the trunk. But if you found the other side, you know, in terms of
yeah.
it looked better as a front, what would you do?
Okay.
Yeah, so if the other side had better shari or better movement or something more interesting that I wanted to show off, then I would switch it to the opposite side. So, you know, some of that is, it's quite a subjective, sort of the art side of bonsai, but in general, there are a few things that you can look for. You know, does it have shari? Does it have more movement on one side or the other? Or is, does one angle give you less perpendicular and parallel lines to the ground? And then you can go from there in terms of designing the branches to frame those interesting parts of the tree. So in the case of this tree, it's much more interesting from this side, in my opinion, because of this hollow at the base here. さっきの質問がどうして、ここを正面にしたって聞かれたんですけど、まあ一番最初に言ったんですけど、この部分がこの木には一番面白いとこだから、ここを正面にしました。
现在呢，五棵树基本上组合完成了。那个下面呢，就是做出地形，加上一些石头。
Now I have placed five trees on the plate, and now I'm adding some rocks. 今五つの木を並びました。今から石を乗せていきます。
在中国这个盆景里面，很喜欢放一点石头。
In China, we like to use rocks in the 盆景。
从那个1300年前那个藏怀太子墓的壁画，这些你有的，那上面就用了石头。后来一直到现在都喜欢。
As you can see in some of the paintings over there, from about 1,300 years ago, we already started to use rocks in Penjing. 中国ではその盆栽に石を乗せることがすごく好きです。そこらにある絵にも書いてるんですけども、1300年ぐらい前にもうすでにそういうことをやっています。
放上了石头以后呢，它增加了这种盆景的这种山林的这种野趣。
When we place some rocks in Penjing, it's closer to nature. この石を乗せることによって、もっと自然に近い感じがします。
不要紧。啊，没有，上面没有了。 这些石头呢是中国的广东的硬德石。
I brought these rocks from Guangdong province in China. この石は関東省から持ってきました。
In a Penjing, will you ever add a dead tree to it?
Sometimes we do. 中国のペンジンでは ジンを使いますかという質問ですけど、はい、時々使います。 And any questions? Any other questions?
Yes, all right. Mm, general.
Yeah. 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 是喷喷一点水，要不然请他先喷一点水。Yes. Yeah. Yo, 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 yo. 现在呢，在铺种这个苔藓，苔藓因为它上去以后可以保护这个土，不会让它流失。同时呢，它也是像这个自然界的那种绿色的植物一样。
We're putting moss on. One reason is to to fix the dirt so the dirt won't go out, and another reason is to make it more make it look more natural. で、今はあの苔を乗せています。2つの理由がありまして、1つ目はこの土を固定するためです。で、2つ目はもっと自然により近い感じになる理由です。
Okay, so while these fellows are wiring up the last few small branches towards the top of the tree, I'm going to start cleaning and placing the branches in their final position from the bottom to the top. So, 上の枝が欠けていただいているので、僕は下から枝をこう直していってます。
Again, there were 5 trees used in this arrangement. Could one use more, like 7, or fill it up more if he had the time, or is it his style, or what should one do?
他问您，就是现在有五棵哦。嗯。就如果你有更多的时间的话，你可以用7棵吧，可以
选
择更多的
树。可以，也可以用七棵。我考虑，因为只有2个小时。
The answer is yes. You can use 7 or more, but he only has less than 2 hours. That's why he chose only 5.
もっと時間があれば、例えば、今5つの木があるんですけど、7つとかもっと、使うことあるんでしょうかという質問ですが、答えははい、もっと時間があればもっと使いたいと思いますが、今日は2時間しかないので、今日はとりあえず5つ使っています。
但是如果用切割的话，也不会把它做得很密的，还是做得比较疏有疏有密。
If you use 7 trees, it's still good. They're still gonna have a lot of space in between. He thinks it's still good. もし7つ使おうとしても、そのスペースがたくさん、今とあんまり変わらなくスペースがたくさんあるので、7つでも全然大丈夫です。
I have a question right here. What was the largest number of trees in any one project he worked on?
用过几十棵，一种很细的，有一种非常细的做的一种丛林，很远的这种远景的丛林，用了很多棵树，大概有20几棵，我记不清了。
In other projects, he has used more than 20 small trees, 20 or 30 small trees. 最も多く使った数は何本でしょうかという質問ですが、一つの作品には最も多く使ったのは20か30ぐらいがあります。
拿过来，能不能放上去
？Bjorn, Bjorn,
让大家看得清楚一点。
If so, how much longer will you let them grow?
Good question. It depends on how the tree responds to what we're doing to it now. This really isn't that extreme, though. I mean, we did cut quite a bit off, but in terms of the branches that we've left on, nothing has been bent too severely. So I don't think it'll be an issue to do a full decandling on this tree this year. Typically in Japan, from about June 15th or so onward, we'll start decandling the largest pines. So this tree we would probably decandle right about that time. So maybe the 10th or the 15th of June would be when we would start thinking about decandling this tree. But it should be no issue this year. It really just depends on how it responds to this kind of work. さっき聞かれたのが、今年目切りしても大丈夫ですかって聞かれたんですけど、まあ、結構枝を切っちゃったんですけど、まあ、木が弱っていったらそんなに目切りはできないと思うんですけれども、でもこの木は元気で、でそんなに枝いっぱい切ったんですけど、多分芽がだんだん出てくるから、6月の間に目切りしても全然大丈夫だと思います、今年は。
すいません、中国は広いですけれども、すいません、中国は広い国土ですけれども、地域によってそのこういう盆栽が好まれるとか、地域ごとの好みみたいのはあるんでしょうか、中国では。
是的，这它因为各个地方的自然景观不同，因为盆景是受了这个自然的树木的影响，因为中国地方太大了，像北方的树和南方的树很不一样，所以说就会有在盆景上有体现的不同的风格。
その通りです。中国がとっても広いので、地域によって自然形式が全く違っていくので、でその地域の人はやっぱり自分のその地域の自然が好むなので、違いますね。はい。So the question is, China is so big,
do people from different regions like different types of style? And the answer is yes. Because China is so big, depends on the region, the nature is completely different. So of course, that the person from that region likes the nature of their region. So it's very different.
我在中国的江苏，是在中部地区，靠近东部沿海。我们那边的像附近的像安徽啦、浙江啦这些山上的松树啦，我是大多数是我们盆景的一个范本吧，就是说盆景就是到这些树木。我们不是南方的松树，也不是那个最北方的松树。
So I'm from the middle part of China. It's close to Shanghai, and it's not north, it's not south. So we're pretty much the standard of everything.
私は中国の中部から参りました。北部ではなく南部でもないので、私たちの地域は一番標準的なスタイルになります。
All right, so what I'm doing now in placing the final branches into their proper position is I'm basically taking everything and fanning it out like a hand. I'm not trying to do too much layering to get kind of a full effect to the tree. I just want to create sort of a basic hand shape pattern to the branches. A tree like this, even though it's old, should backbud relatively easily in these back areas here. So by doing this, we expose the upper portion of the branch to light and air. If we fertilize properly, treat the tree properly over the next few years, it should backbud quite nicely, and you'll get that nice fullness along the z-axis there, rather than trying to layer things to get the same effect. So in the long run, that's a better approach to developing branches on a pine like this.
今僕がやってるのが、なんていうんですか、手みたいな感じで枝をこう広げていってます。そうすると、枝の上に太陽が当たって、で胴吹きはします。夏の間に肥料をやって水やったりとかしてたら、その、枝の上からちょっと胴吹きしますので、枝がフルに見えるようになります。そうすると。
差不多了，差不多了。五分钟。
All right, just as I mentioned at the beginning of the demo, we would figure out exactly what we wanted to do with this gin at the top of the tree at the end. If it was too loud, we'd make it smaller or get rid of it. If it looked okay, we would leave it. In my opinion, it's a bit too loud for the tree right now. So what I'm going to do is take off part of this section here and remove most of this. We'll leave this at the top for now, but this to me is just too fat and weighty right in the front there, so I'm going to remove that.
今の状態でこの、天神がちょっとうるさいのでちょっと、小さく、していきたいですね。まずはこれを残して、でこの下にある部分を取って、でここは結構太いのでそれも細く、します。
时间差不多了，那个我再说两句，好吧？
We're almost finished.
因为今天这个做这种丛林，不像杂木的那种树枝等等要修剪，这每一棵树要扎，所以比较费时间，所以用了五棵树。
Because every tree it needs to be trimmed and wired, that's why we only used 5 trees today.
假如 OK.
就是今啊。すみません。今日は、ちょっと時間かかったので、このそれぞれ、切ったり、針金かけたり、とか必要だったので、時間が必要だったので、今日は5つの木にしました。
如果要用七棵树的话呢、就增加两棵的话、可能就是位置要做一些调整了。在，也可能在，现在的这个布局还不怎么好讲。
If we plan to use 7 trees, there's gonna be more adjustment. もし7つの木にすれば、もうちょっと他のスタイルになります。
那个，我想再说一说的，就是这个空间，整个这个树啦，留下了很多的空间，特别是这里中间的这个一大片。
Now I want to talk about space. 今から空間について話したいと思っています。特にこの前の部分すごく空いてるとみんながわかると思います。If you look at the front, there is a huge space.
这里的是靠的比较紧的。这里也是靠的比较紧的，中间的是比较空的，就是把疏和密的变化在这里体现出来。
You can see on the left side and also on the right side, these trees are very close to each other. But in the middle, there's a huge space. この左側と右側とても木と木すごく短いと思いますが、この真ん中わざと開くようにしてるんです。そうすることによってその差を感じます。So some parts are gathered together, some parts you leave a big space so you can feel the difference.
整个的这个布局就是主次，这块是主，这块是次。
You can see this part is going to be the main part, and that is going to be the sub area. 見たら分かると思いますが、こっちはメインで、そっちはサブとなります。
其中这两棵是基本上是直的树，向上长的。这边的树是这个旁边的树是斜一点，这样的就是有一种线条的变化。
This tree, as you can see, they're straight, and all one, two, three, these three are leaning towards the other side. So you can feel the difference between the beauty of the lines.
この真ん中の2つはまっすぐ立ってまして、
隣のこの3つは斜めになっているんですけど、そうすることによってその線の美しさを感じることができます。
我们呢喜欢其实在在这个下面啦，摘一点不同的小草，那种三叶草。
In China, we like to place some grass sub plants around the roots.
Okay.
中国ではこの下の根の部分にこの草とか植えることが好きです。
Okay. 今天就坐到这里吧，这个示范表演只能是把做一个示范。那个，谢谢大家。
今日はこれで終わりです。ありがとうございました。Thank you very much。
谢谢三位，谢谢三位助手，和翻译。好看。
一言言わせていただきます。ちょうど時間になりましたので、見事に時間内で二人とも終わりました。良かったと思います。拍手をどうぞ。はい。それと。 この木もなかなか難しくてどういうふうに作るかなと思って彼が、私も心配してました。そうしましたら思った通りの姿に作り上げた。これはもう本当に見事だったと思います。
ありがとうございます。ありがとうございます。So Mr. Kimura-san said that when he saw this tree to begin with and he saw that I was going to be doing it, he was very worried. But he said that, that I designed it in the image that he would have designed it in as well. So that's very nice of him to say that.
これは本当に
ありがとうございます。
これでまたこれから3年4年と管理培養を上手にすればこの木は素晴らしい木に生まれ変わります。今日がこの木 の, あの盆栽の盆栽としてのスタートの一歩なんですね。
So he said that over the course of the next three or four years, if this tree is taken well care of, it'll become an excellent plant. And he thinks that it's one of the better pieces of material to start with for the demo material this time around. So he quite likes this tree.
この仕事を始める前の写真、あの写真撮られた方もおると思いますけれども、その写真とこの写真と、まあ後で見比べてください。
He said many of you probably took pictures of this tree before the demo started. Pull those pictures out and compare the two images, and he thinks that you'll be very surprised at the difference.
これは本当に大きく変わって本当に良くなりました。ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございました。 Thank you very much.
はい、それからこのこちらの五葉松の寄せ植えなんですね。まあ非常にこれは難しいんですよ。それで本人の希望でどうしてもその蔵前市に寄せ植えを作りたいという希望がありまして、まあ、こういう材料を私どもで揃えたんですけども、揃えた中から選び出してこれだけのものを作ったんです。なかなかあの雰囲気のある自然の風景が出てると思いますけど、どうですか皆さん。
This forest style is very difficult, but according to his wish, and everything looks perfect. So, what do you guys think? Do you think it's good? Yeah!
Thank you.
本当によくできたと思います。はい、ご苦労様、ありがとう。
Very well done. Thank you very much.
Thank you. 谢谢木村先生帮我挑选的材料。
あの通訳をしていただいたこのお二人、本当にご苦労様でした。じゃあ皆様これで終わりにさせていただきます。いろいろと長い時間ありがとうございました。
ありがとうござい
ます。ザオチンチェンさん、ビヨンビオホルムさん、そして解説をお務めいただきました磯部茂雄さん、通訳のチェンナンシーさん、アシスタントの大島健二さん、今井千春さん、森山義彦さん、前岡直樹さん、ありがとうございました。さあ次回の焦点ステージプログラムはこの後3時30分より第8回世界盆栽大会 in 埼玉、日本の盆栽水石焦点の最後を飾るグランドフィナーレをお送りいたします。皆さんもぜひ一緒に盛り上げてください。